Hallelujah. It's 6 p.m. West African time, 17 hours GMT. It's time for the patterns. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you for joining me today. It's someone out there that has joined. Let me know where you are joining from. I would like you to call someone, tell someone, to tell someone, to tell someone that the patterns is on. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I was singing that song, what a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus Christ. We give him all the glory, all the honor, all the adoration, and all the praise for the privilege to see this broadcast of the patterns in the second half of the year 2020. The fact that you are watching me today or hearing me today is a proof that God has been good to you and God has been good to me. We thank God for the gift of life. We thank him for all that he has done. We give him the glory and we give him the praise in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I would like you to start a watch party with this broadcast. Call your friends. Let them know that the patterns is on. It's going to be short, it's going to be sharp, and it's going to be punchy. I welcome you to this broadcast of the patterns after a month-long episode, special episode on marriage is for destiny. Once again, I celebrate and I appreciate my wife who was with me on set all through the month of June. We decided to dedicate it to our 10th-year wedding anniversary. We thank everyone who greeted us, everyone who prayed for us, everyone who appreciated us, everyone who celebrated us. God will cause you to celebrate and to rejoice also. And we shall come to rejoice with you very soon in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I would like you to go to all our social media platforms, the Facebook page at The Script Ministry and the YouTube page at The Script Ministry and Oluwagbemiga Durojaye. There are a lot of videos there that will be a blessing to you. Lessons that we have learned these past 10 years of our marriage and many other videos that are there that will be a blessing to you. I go there from time to time. I watch those messages again. I listen to them again. I share with my friends. And I must tell you the fact, I'm always blessed when I watch those broadcasts and when I watch those videos or listen to the audio of those broadcasts. So go there. We shared a lot with you. We had about 4 series of Marriage is for Destiny. And then we've had past series, you know, that will really bless you. Things like The Reason for You, Who Are You, Seize the Moment, Time and Chance, you know, all those things that we've shared on this platform. They are very, very rich messages. I would like you to go to our YouTube pages, go to our Facebook page, like, watch, share, and above all, subscribe. And make sure that you press the notification bell so that anytime we upload any video, you'll get notified from time to time. Hallelujah. I believe God is set to reach out to someone today, even in the short time that we have, and you will be mightily blessed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I was pondering over a statement made by the former president of the United States of America, Woodrow Wilson. Woodrow Wilson was the 28th president of America, was the president of the United States of America from the year 1913 to the year 1921. He was president for about 8 years. He made a very powerful statement, and that is what I just want to share with you today. Remember that the focus of the patterns is on purpose and destiny. The man made a very powerful statement. He said, when money is lost, nothing is lost. When money is lost, nothing is lost. He said, when health is lost, something is lost. When health is lost, something is lost. He said, but when character is lost, everything is lost. When character is lost, everything is lost. Wow, what a powerful statement. When money is lost, nothing is lost. When health is lost, yes, something is lost. But when character is lost, everything is lost. Do you know why? Because character is the foundation upon which life and destiny is built. Every other thing that you acquire or accomplish in life is built on the foundation of character. And the Bible says, if the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? So once the foundation of character is destroyed, every other thing will crumble. Every other thing, no matter how elegant you have built, no matter how high and gigantic you have built, no matter the edifice that you have built, once the foundation is destroyed, every other thing will collapse. I will share with you today a few personalities, both from the scriptures and in our contemporary times. I will share with you, first of all, the story of Joseph. You know him very well. Joseph is, if you are going to talk about destiny and you want a reference from the Bible, then Joseph is number one. He had a glorious future ahead of him. He had a glorious promise of a glorious future, which your destiny is. The Bible says, for those whom we foreknew, we predestinated. Those whom we predestinated, they called. Those whom we called, they justified. And those whom we justified, he glorified. So the end point of every destiny is glory. So you have a glorious destiny ahead of you, just like Joseph did. But the Bible says in Genesis 39, from verse 6, the Bible says Joseph was a handsome man. And he was well built. And the Bible says his master's wife cast her eyes on him. She lusted after him. And then from time to time, she will approach Joseph and say, come and lie with me. Come and lie with me. Handsome boy, you look so good today. Come and lie with me. The Bible says every time Joseph refused her, every time Joseph turned back, no, from her. But the Bible says there came a certain day that Joseph was alone in the house and all the other servants, nobody else was at home. I ask you today, what do you do when nobody else is around? What do you do when nobody else is watching? What do you do when nobody else is seeing you? The Bible says Joseph was left alone. He was left alone. He was left alone. And then she came at him again. The Bible says she kept pressurizing him. How many of us have compromised under pressure? How many of us have given in under pressure? The Bible says day by day, she pressed on Joseph. She pressed on Joseph. She pressed on Joseph. But Joseph resisted. You know why? Every child of destiny, every man and woman of destiny, it's like a pregnant woman. A pregnant woman doesn't just eat anything. A pregnant woman doesn't just go anywhere. You know, when you're about to enter an x-ray room, you will see the sign there. Please tell us if you are pregnant. You will see for most medications, most drugs, they will ask you, please consult your physician, consult your doctor if you are pregnant. If you must use this medication, then make sure that you consult. Why? Because you are carrying something precious. Because you are carrying something, the same way you are a child of destiny, the same way you are a child of destiny, you are carrying something precious. You are carrying something valuable. I want you to treasure what you carry. That was the mentality that Joseph carried. He knew that he carried something precious. I can't trade away this dream. I can't trade away this glorious future just on the platform of, you know, sexual enjoyment of how many minutes. So he resisted her, or to the point that the woman, the Bible says, when he was left alone, she came at him again and grabbed him by the clothes. Some of us would have given up at that point. That I say she was the one that helped me. She was the one that held my clothes. You know, she grabbed him by the clothes. But the Bible says that Joseph, some versions of the Bible say, he tore himself away from her. The Bible says he removed the clothes and he ran out naked. Oh, he said, I better go out naked than to commit this evil. You know, he told the woman, he said, my master has committed everything into my hands. There's nothing in this house that he has not given me access to, except you. And because you are his wife, how can I do this wicked thing and sin against God? He had a character of a godly conscience. He had a character of forthrightness, of faithfulness. He was loyal. He was committed to his boss. So he had a character test, and thank God he succeeded. No wonder eventually, few years down the line, he emerged the prime minister of Egypt. Remember, when money is lost, nothing is lost. When health is lost, something is lost. But when character is lost, everything is lost. Everything is lost. So Joseph had the test of character, but thank God, by the grace of God, he did not fail. He did not fail. He did not fail. You know, there's a, have I faced temptations before? Yes, I have. Have I been embattled with temptations before? Yes, I have. We are not free from temptations. But when you remember that you are a child of destiny, when you remember that you carry something precious, then you will not give in to pressure. You will not give in to temptations. I've faced several temptations in my life before. I could remember during my NYSC, there was a particular temptation I faced. You know, there was pleasure to enjoy, you know, but I said no. I went back. I know when I got back to my room, you know, mosquito infested room with just mattress on the floor, whereas some people were offering me something more pleasurable somewhere else, you know, with a lot of things to enjoy overnight with. But you know, I said no. When I got back, you know, to my room, one thought came to my mind. I said, Gbenga, all your life, you have been a true Christian. You have been a committed Christian. You have been a brother. You have been good. Just enjoy yourself for once. Nobody knows you here. In this state, nobody knows you. That was my first night, you know, in my local government. I said, oh, I see doctor. I said, nobody knows you here. For once, enjoy yourself. Abba, you've kept yourself all these years. For once, you know, enjoy yourself. Give yourself some pleasure. But I said, no, I will not compromise. I carry something precious. I have a glorious future ahead of me. I can't trade it on the altar of enjoyment of how many minutes. Remember, once character is lost, everything is lost. Little did I know that I had one or two people who had been looking up to me in university days in the same state serving with me. It was later I found out. If I had messed up, you know, they would have just looked at me like, oh, so all that this guy did on campus, all that this guy did in university days were just a mirage, were just, you know, what they call photo tricks, you know, were just for the optics. You know, that means this guy was not a genuine Christian. This guy was not a serious Christian. He could have destroyed their own faith too, even in Christ, you know, but thank God for his grace. Thank God for his grace. When character is lost, everything is lost. Another person I would like to share with you is Samson. You know him very well. You know, the Bible says in Judges chapter 16, verse 1, he went to a harlot. He went to a prostitute and he slept with her. He forgot the covenant he had with God. He forgot that he was a Nazarene, separated unto God. He didn't mind the precious thing that he carried. He despised what he carried. He despised his glorious destiny. And then he lied with the prostitute. And then the men of the city came to arrest him and laid wait for him till morning. But the Bible says when it was midnight, he got up. He saw that they had locked the gate of the city. He said, this won't be a restriction or hindrance to me. He lifted and uprooted the gate of the city along with the pillars and carried it up to the top of the mountain or to the top of the hill where he was going to. You know, that was so much strength, so much anointing, so much power. So he got away with it. And so he felt, oh, I can always get away with it. And then just immediately he fell in love with Delilah again. And Delilah, you know, asked him a number of questions. And it was evident, it was obvious that this lady was after your heart. This lady is after your destruction. But yet, you know, Samson kept playing the games with her. Oh, what is the source of your strength? Oh, if you bind me with new bowstrings, you know, then I will, that are not yet dry, then I will lose my strength. She bound him, and then he broke himself free when she called the Philistines upon him. And she called the Philistines, you should have been sensitive that this person was after you, but no, he kept on. And then she told him, he told her again, he said, oh, if I'm bound with new ropes that have never been used before, I will lose my strength. She bound him with new ropes. He broke himself free. He said, if my ear is made into a lump and then nailed to the wall, pinned down, then my strength will be lost. And then she did that again and he broke himself free. And then eventually he told her his secret. And he said, I'm a Nazarene, I've never cut my hair. And the Bible says when Delilah heard this and she knew that he had told her his heart, she called the Philistines, shaved his hair, made him to sleep on her laps, shaved his hair, and then called in the Philistines. The Bible says something striking in that Judges chapter 16. After she shaved his hair, the Bible says, thus Delilah started pulling Samson down and eventually destroyed him. What is that thing that has been pulling you down? You've been getting away with it. You've been getting away with it. What is that dangerous habit? What is that dangerous character? Is it pride? Is it arrogance? Is it, you know, non-control of your tongue? Is it taste for something in particular? You know, is it one temptation that you find difficult to control, to resist? You know, what is that thing you have been getting away with? You have to be careful. If you don't stop it, it will eventually stop you. If you don't stop it, it will eventually stop you. Bible says that when she called him again and he said, Samson, the Philistines are upon you, he shook himself, expecting to break through or break free like before. The Bible says he never knew that God had left him. He never knew that God had left him. I pray for someone under the sound of my voice, the enemy will not succeed in pulling you down. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray for you, your enemies, your adversaries, especially the devil, will not succeed in pulling your life, your destiny, your career down. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, that is what happens. I saw something as a young man in Proverbs chapter 6 verse 26, and he has kept me for life. When I'm faced with temptations, yes, I'm human. All those emotions are running. The hormones are running. You know, you are faced with temptations. But I remember Proverbs chapter 6 verse 26. The Bible says, for by means of a warish woman, by means of a promiscuous woman, you can interchange it also for a man if you're a woman, but by means of a promiscuous man, a man is become a piece of bread. No matter what you have achieved, remember, when character is lost, everything is lost. Everything is lost. No matter what you have built, no matter what you have achieved, when character is lost, everything crumbles. The Bible says, for by means of a warish woman, a man will become a piece of bread. And the adulterous woman, the adulterous man will seek for the precious life. If you see them swarming towards you, if you see those temptations coming your way like that, it is because you carry something precious. You know, they say in my place that it is only the tree that has fruits that people throw sticks at. If you don't have any fruit on it, nobody will be throwing sticks at it. So when you see temptations swarming your way, when you see the devil trying to, you know, face you with all manner of temptations and tricks, oh, why don't you choose this? Why don't you go this way? It is because you carry something precious. Child of God, child of destiny, remember, you are like a pregnant woman. You can't enter every place. You can't eat everything. You can't swallow everything like every other person does, because you carry something precious that you don't want to get harmed, or you don't want to get hurt by your actions or your inactions, or by what you take in, or by your particular taste for something, or because you are careful of what you are carrying. When you talk of people in contemporary times, these are things that are already in the media, so it's not that I'm trying to malign any character, but I look at two people especially that I've learned a lot from, you know, in recent times. The first person is Lance Armstrong. I don't know if you know, Lance Armstrong was a very popular, he was an icon cyclist. He was a cyclist, and between 1998 and 2005, Lance Armstrong won the Tour de France. Tour de France is the peak, is like the World Cup for football. Tour de France is the peak of cycling for every professional cyclist. He won the Tour de France back to back to back to back for 7 consecutive years. No man had ever done that before. When he won it the 7th year, in fact, the president of America invited him to the White House, you know, to have a chat, to have dinner with him. You know, he made a lot of name. But shortly after then, allegations started coming that he was into doping. And eventually in 2013, he confessed with his own mouth that he was into doping. And do you know what happened? They stripped him of all the 7 awards. All the 7 awards. All the 7 awards. All the companies that he was, you know, representing before, they withdrew their contracts. He lost, you know, billions of dollars and all of that. Why? Just because of character. When character is lost, everything is lost. I want to believe it is possible that within those 7 consecutive years, there were some tournaments he won without being on drugs. But because he had been, you know, found out to have been doping or to have been on drugs, everything he won, he lost. Remember, when money is lost, nothing is lost. When health is lost, something is lost. But when character is lost, everything is lost. Everything is lost. A wise man said, we employ people because of what they know, and we sack them because of who they are. If you don't watch that character, if you don't watch that negative flaw in your character, if you don't watch that flaw in your character, it may pull down your career. It may pull down your destiny. It may pull down your dreams. It may pull down your vision. It may pull down that glorious future ahead of you. You need to watch your character. You need to watch your character. You need to watch your character. Another person, if you remember, is a very popular golf player, Tiger Woods. You know, Tiger Woods was number one golf player for over 600 weeks. Can you imagine? He was number one golf player for more than 600 weeks. Calculate the number of years that was. But he had, you know, allegations of, you know, being unfaithful, infidelity, you know, to his wife and to his marriage vow. And then, you know, before you knew it, mistresses started showing up. This woman would say, no, he slept with me against my will and all of that. And then his world came crashing down. One day he had an argument with his wife because of all these extramarital affairs. And then he went out to drink. And when he was coming back, he had a number of accidents. He hit the car against a number of things on the street. And then the police came and met him, you know, drunk right there. The car engine was on. And then that was the beginning of the end of his career, as it were. You know, for 14 years, the man that was number one for 600 and something weeks became, it was so bad, it dropped to more than 400 in the ranking. If you count first 400 golfers, I'm sure maybe I will even be among them all over the world. He was more than, he fell to below 400 in his ranking. But thank God for his mercies. Last year, 2019, after 14 years, he won his first major tournament again. God restored his destiny. And that's the word I've brought for someone today. You might have fallen character-wise. You might have compromised your character. You might have compromised, and maybe you have, as it were, aborted that vision, aborted that destiny, aborted that dream that God has given to you. God is merciful. God is merciful. We saw that in the life of Samson. He prayed again. The Bible says his eyes, his ears began to grow again, and he prayed unto God. And the Bible says he killed more people at his death than at his lifetime. And if you read the book of Hebrews 11, Samson was mentioned among the heroes of faith. So eventually, I'm sure when we get to heaven, we'll see Samson in heaven. So God can restore you. I brought a word of hope to someone. Have you compromised your character? Have you compromised your faith? Have you compromised your dreams? Have you compromised on your destiny just because of pleasure, just because of that employment, just because of that contract, just because of that job, just because of that relationship? You have compromised. I want you to cry out to God for mercy right now. Just ask him to have mercy on you and restore you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Please talk to God in prayer. Say, Lord, I'm sorry. In every way I've compromised in terms of character. In every way I've compromised the faith. Lord, just for pleasures of few minutes, I plead for your mercy. Please have mercy on me, Lord. Thank you for your mercy. In Jesus' name, amen. I pray for everyone under the sound of my voice who has compromised one way or the other. I pray that the grace and mercy of God will locate you right now. You will be restored. God will restore your vision. He will restore your dreams. He will restore your destiny. Just like Samson eventually at least accomplished his mission, you will accomplish your mission here on earth in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray for everyone out there who has not known, identified with Jesus Christ as his personal Lord or Savior, or a personal Lord and Savior. I want to say this prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I'm sorry for all my sins. I realize today that I need you in my life. Please forgive my sins and wash me clean with your precious blood. From today, I confess of all my sins and I repent of all of them. From today, I believe in my heart and I confess with my mouth that Jesus Christ is my Lord and my Savior. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. In Jesus' name, amen. Congratulations. I pray that the grace of God will uphold you to the very end in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. If you said that prayer with me, I would like you to get in touch with us. The WhatsApp number is there. Please send a WhatsApp to us. Say, I gave my life to Christ on the patterns. We'd like to keep praying for you. We'd like to chat you up and then follow you up in your journey with Jesus. Hallelujah. I pray for everyone under the sound of my voice today who has been a part of this broadcast. I pray that you will not fall. I pray that you will not fail. I pray that you will not fumble. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray that in the race of life, in the race of destiny, you will not be substituted. No one will take your place. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, grace to stand, grace to stand, grace to stand against all temptations. Receive it now. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray for you that you not lose your reward. You will eat the target. You will receive the prize. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, you will not lose your crown. In the mighty name of Jesus, thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, Amen. Hallelujah. It's been a wonderful time with you this evening. Thank you for joining us. Everyone who joined, I appreciate you joining us for all our broadcasts. I would like you once again, share this video with your friends. Start a watch party with it. And go to our YouTube channel. Like, watch, subscribe, and share as many. And then don't forget to press the notification button. Once again, I want to appreciate everyone. And I believe that you have been blessed by the few that we have shared today. I repeat that quote, Woodrow Wilson, 28th President of the United States of America, said, "When money is lost, nothing is lost. When health is lost, something is lost. But when character is lost, everything is lost." You will not lose everything in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Till I come your way again on another episode of The Patterns, please watch out for Church on the Waves next Tuesday. It's going to be awesome. I'm starting this new series as inspired by the Holy Spirit. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be wonderful. Please make sure that you join us. God bless you. Till I come your way again, I love you. Stay blessed. Go out there and fulfill your destiny. In Jesus' name, amen. Bye.